Hi, my name is Adelanda Cameron. I'm an environmental science student at the University of Houston Clear Lake, and I'm an intern at the Environmental Institute of Houston this semester. This is a presentation on Texas bluebells. Texas bluebells, otherwise known as Eustoma exaltatum, are from the Gentian family. They have multiple common names, including the Prairie Gentian and the Showy Prairie Gentian. The flowers are bell-shaped with upright stems with a blue to light violet bell bloom with white gradient from center. They can grow up to 1.5 feet with their blooming time mainly in the summer. Texas bluebells grow individually. The flowers are pentamerous, meaning they have 5 petals and their width is about 2 to 4 inches. The leaves grow in opposite orientation and are deciduous, meaning the leaves will fall off at the end of the growing season. When the seed capsule ripens, the stalk may be cut back 2 or 3 inches above the ground for maintenance. They are very popular in other countries like Japan, where they have been bred and hybridized for their beauty for over 70 years. Texas bluebells prefer moist, sandy, and loamy soil. They also grow best with full or partial access to sunlight. Depending on where they are grown, the growth cycle can be annual, biennial, or perennial. They are found naturally in moist, well-drained areas around streams and riverbeds, and they grow best in well-watered, well-drained gardens. Due to overpicking of naturally grown bluebells, they are much less common than they were a few decades ago. Unfortunately, the overpicking makes it hard for them to be pollinated and spread their seeds, but people have expanded their habitat by spreading them to different regions. When growing in the garden, plan to propagate at the end of March. The seeds are very small and can be somewhat difficult to work with, but they have a higher germination rate through surface seeding when sunlight is able to penetrate them. For best results, germinate the seeds in a warm 70 to 75 degree environment. For more resources and more information, visit the Native Plant Society of Texas.